Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we'll be working on getting space images with NASA APOD API, the Astronomy Picture of the Day API. If you have any questions about the code or anything resulting from this video, feel free to join the Discord on screen or the link in the description, and we'll be glad to help you out. So now let's demonstrate space, and it's given us a picture of a shepherd moon of Saturn. So now let's jump into the code. Okay, we need to import a couple things: Discord, IOHTTP, and JSON. We need IOHTTP because it's asynchronous and non-blocking, and requests will be blocking. So basically what will happen is that if someone else tries to run a command while your bot is trying to use requests, it's gonna block. So basically it won't respond to that. So it's really important that you use IOHTTP. Okay, now let's import daytime and commands. Okay, now let's define our bot as our Discord bot. And now let's define our servers as a list of guild IDs that we want slash commands to be pushed out instantaneously. Okay, now let's actually work on an event. So whenever our bot comes online, it's gonna print our terminal that we've logged in. So let's create our first slash command space. Okay, so what this does is that it pushes out the slash command to the servers in this list, and it's going to call it space, and its description is going to be gets random space images. So now let's add a cooldown for the command, because you don't want people spamming this. Okay, so this creates a cooldown, so it's one command per every 5 seconds per user. Okay, we want to defer first in case that this request takes a while. Okay, now let's create a IOHTTP client session to get the images from the API. Okay, so basically this creates a client session with IOHTTP, and then it gets the URL and as a response. Okay, so now we need to get our API key as well as get the link for the API. Okay, you want to go to api.nasa.gov and you want to generate an API key. You need your first name, last name, email, and they'll send you an API key. So, but for now, we'll be here are the rate limits. I'll leave this in the description as well. But for now, we'll just be using the demo key. Okay, so you want to copy this URL and you want to add a parameter count equals one. So since we only want one image. Okay, let's test this link first. And so this is what it will look like. So we'll be wanting to get the date, the explanation, the URL, the image, and the title. Okay, so now we want to wait for the response. Okay, so this is the main gist of it. So first we await for the response as text, and I don't know why, but for whatever reason I had to replace the brackets, and then we load the JSON and we get the title as the title. We try to get the URL as the HD URL that we saw here. HD URL and URL. So they're the same links, it looks like, but sometimes the HD URL isn't there, especially for older images. And then we get the explanation, the date, and then we create an embed. So the title is the title, the description is the explanation, the timestamp is the current time, since this is timestamp aware, and the color is purple. We set the image as this URL, and the text as from date, so the user can know when the image was taken. and then we respond with them back. Then we get our token. So you want to keep this token safe. By the time you see this video, it'll already be regenerated. Okay, now let's work on error handling, especially for our error handling for our cooldown. So we want to create an event, so whenever there's an application command error, whenever a slash command has an error, we check if it's because the command is on cooldown. Okay, so basically what occurs here is that whenever there's an application command error, or whenever a slash command has an error, we check if it's because the command is on cooldown. If it is, we're going to respond with an error. The error is going to contain saying, you are on cooldown, please try again in XYZ seconds. And then if it's not caused by this cooldown, then we're going to raise the error and it's going to print in the terminal. So now let's run the code. Oh, I also want to repeat that this token is really important. You'll want to keep this safe. I'll have this regenerated by the time you see this video. Okay, now let's go to Discord and test it. If we use space, we get an image, and if we try to hit the rate limit, it says that you are on cooldown, try again in 3.02 seconds. If you found this video helpful, please consider liking the video and subscribing. We're also planning on doing bot reviews soon, so join our Discord if you want us to review your bot. And if you have any questions, feel free to comment down below or join our Discord. And thank you for watching.